What's up, people? I'm King Jern from the Frocast and NappyAfro.com, and today we are ranking every Outkast album. Sorry, Outkast fans and old hip-hop heads, we are never getting another album from Andre and Big Boy. While this sort of thing of ranking Outkast albums has been done before, Nappy Afro has never done it. Plus, it's always a good time to celebrate the work of the best hip-hop duo of all time. Yeah, I said it. Let's start the countdown. Number 6, Idlewild, released on August 22nd, 2006. We hate to start off on a bad note. I don't care what Wikipedia says, Idlewild isn't an official Outkast album. It was a soundtrack. The end. The best song on Idlewild, Mighty O, with the worst song being everything besides Mighty O, Morris Brown, and Hollywood Divorce. Moving on. Number 5, Speakerbox, The Love Below, released on September 23rd, 2003. Outkast's biggest album. Not only is this the Atlanta duo's best-selling album, going on to sell 10 million copies, it also won Album of the Year, the second hip-hop album to do so, if you count The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Weirdly enough, it might be the group's least cohesive album too. It's just two solo albums put together. They weren't together on many tracks, and you could see the different directions their music was going. The best song on this album, Prototype. The worst song being Ghetto Music. Shout out to Patti LaBelle though. Number 4, Stankonia, released on October 31st, 2000. This album really showed the growth and the experimentation of the Outkast sound, and picked up where Equimini left off. While critics loved the album, this was a low-key downgrade from Equimini. This may also have been the start of the end of Outkast. The best song on Stankonia, Red Velvet, with the worst song being We Love These Hoes. Number 3, Southern Playlist of Cadillac Music, released on April 26, 1994. This is the one that started it all. Not only is this album my personal favorite from Outkast, but this album also legitimized Southern hip hop in my eyes. There were always good rappers from Atlanta, but this album let the rest of the world know that there were good rappers from Atlanta. The best song on Southern Playlist of Cadillac Music is Get Up, Get Out. Worst song, Funky Ride. Number 2, AT Aliens, released on August 27th, 1996. If you thought Outkast's first album was luck, this album proved the duo was here to stay. This is also Andre and Big Boy's hardest album. The term AT Aliens is still being used to this day. This album might not be received well by those not from the South, but all of us from the South know though. The best song on AT Aliens is Wellin'. Worst song, Millennium. Number 1, Equimini, released on September 29th, 1998. This is their most complete album. Top to bottom, this is the group's best body of work. 5 mics in the source. This is Outkast at the top of their game, and this is the reason why we ranked it number 1. The best song on Equimini is Equimini, come on, of course. With the worst song being Chunky Fire. And that's our ranking of every Outkast album. Did we get it wrong? How would you rank them? Let us know in the comments. Be sure to visit NappyAfro.com, listen to the Frocast, and support the team. I am King Germ, and I'm out. Peace.